been that strictly dealt with by Facebook, but I think that's because of the war. And nobody in Washington wants to be criticized about anything either, so, in that regard. So I'm in Facebook jail, evidently. So she's going to use her account. All right, David will lead us.
I have the soul that Jesus gave me.
sing your part, no accompaniment. Ready?
Oh, how I love Jesus.
Given us the ability to read some music and sing parts, sometimes sing parts even without reading the music. You know, some people can do that. And so that's why we do what we do. I grew up under a man singing, a Coast Guard officer who used to lead the music in the church where I grew up as a boy, and on Sunday evenings, he would get them singing early. The service started at 7. By 6:20 or so, he'd get everyone singing as they were coming in. It wasn't the official, you know, service hadn't really started yet, but he'd get everybody singing. And by the time the service actually was, you know, the time to begin, and then we sang more. The roof was already lifting up off that place, amen. And people were excited about what they might hear from the Word of God that evening. And we didn't have anything on the wall. You know? There seemed to be more people in that day that could look at a songbook and read the parts. It seemed like there were more people 40, 50 years ago, 60 years ago that could read music than there are now. You know, I would love to have on some Saturday afternoons some young people here teaching them how to read music out of a song. I'd love that. Anyway, did you have one more or you just got special? That's right.
Thank you.
thank you for being the worship team today. Amen. All right, I'm looking at Romans chapter 4, verse 7. We're still in our pamphlet, getting close to the end of it. And this is where I ask questions. I want to read to you, of course, this is my pamphlet, so saving faith is deliberate on your part. We talked about that last week. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the Son of God. So believing is a deliberate thing. Let me turn my mic up. Can you hear me all right? All right. In whom is Jesus Christ? In whom ye also trust? After that ye heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation. So you don't just get a ping somewhere in the brain one day walking down the road or driving down the highway and say, oh, I'm saved. The Lord doesn't just give you a notification and say, you know, yeah, I've saved you now. No, it's the Bible says, in whom ye also trusted after that ye heard the word of truth. The gospel of your salvation, Ephesians chapter 1, verse 13. Acts chapter 16, verse 31. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 15. By him, that's Jesus Christ, therefore let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually, that is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. So the best thing you can do when you've trusted the Lord Jesus Christ, best thing you can do, and you can tell unsaved people this, say, trust Christ, and then the best thing you can do is have a thanksgiving service before the Lord. Amen. Just personally, giving thanks unto his name. The sacrifice of praise to God continually, that is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 15. That is the correct, deliberate response to believing, to knowing that God has done everything that's necessary to get you to heaven and that you can do nothing. In fact, you will have learned by that time that to even attempt to give something will throw up automatically a barrier between you. When men say, well, I'm going to get to God this way, I'm going to get to God that way, or if I do this, God will accept me. Immediately you've thrown up a wall between you and the Savior, between you and the God that wants to save you. So I come down to asking these questions, and I'll go back to Romans. Had you go to Romans. Romans chapter number 4, I'm going to ask you a series of questions. Let's ask the Lord to help us. Heavenly Father, thank you for the good songs. Thank you, Father, for reminding us of your love to us. Thank you for reminding us that you are our friend, that we've never had a finer, greater, deeper, more wonderful friend than our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Help us to glorify him and give him the preeminence even in these next few moments, and bless these that are sitting before us and help them, Father, help them in their own personal evangelism. And that's the effort that we've made.